In this video, I will demonstrate how to import sequence reads in your BioNumerics database. First, you need to make sure a sequence readset experiment is present that will hold the data. To create a new experiment, click on the green plus icon in the toolbar of the experiment types panel and choose the sequence read type option from the list. Specify a name and press OK to confirm the creation of the experiment in the database. The experiment is added to the experiment types panel. To import sequence reads, select File Import or click on the Import button in the toolbar to call the import tree where all the import routines are grouped. With the option Import Sequence Readset Files, sequence reads can be imported and stored inside the relational database. Sequence reads can also be imported as data links in BioNumerics, but this requires the installation of the whole Genome Sequence Tools plugin in the database. I will close the import dialog and go to the plugin dialog to install this plugin. Installation of the plugin is only possible with a valid password and project name linked to a certain amount of credits. After installation of the plugin, I go back to the import dialog where a new import routine is available in the tree. I select the import routine and in the next step I need to specify the data source. I select NCBI in this example and I provide the accession codes in the next step. Here I will specify that the accession codes should be used as key in the database. I double-click on the only row in the grid and select key as data destination. I specify a template name so I can use this import routine again for future imports. My import template is automatically selected in the grid, and I make sure my WGS readset experiment is selected for the storage of the data links. In the last step, I uncheck the option to submit jobs to the external calculation engine, since this will be covered in the next video. I press Finish to import the data links. 14 entries are created and the accession codes are stored in the key field. When I click on one of the green dots in the first column, the link status is shown. For all 14 entries, I have additional information stored in an Excel file. I will import this information in my database. I go to the import tree again and I select the Excel import option under entry information data. I browse for my Excel file. And I link the accession code column in my Excel file to the key field in my BioNumerics database. All other columns in the Excel file can be linked to new entry fields in the database. I select all fields using the Shift key. And select the Entry Info Field option as destination. I confirm the creation of the new fields in the database. I provide a template name for future imports. And press Finish to import the data in my database. The Database Entries panel is updated. This ends this video. Please tune in to our other videos about whole genome SNP to learn more about the workflow in BioNumerics.